Hello students, today we will start a new chapter from English textbook Beehive, prose section chapter 1, The Fun They Had. This chapter aims on developing the sense of belonging to our schools. By the end of this chapter, we will be filled with fresh love, care and respect for our school. I hope you all are also missing your school while sitting at your homes. We are also missing you and all our students. So tell me students, have you ever imagined yourselves, that means our present generation, as the matter of discussion of the past and we are in future? Confused. But there is no need to get confused, because it is where the chapter 1 of our English textbook, prose section, The Fun They Had, will take us to. So today we will start our new chapter, lesson 1 of our English textbook Beehive, The Fun They Had. To understand the title, it simply declares the past events or something entertaining someone had in their past. But what is that fun that they had? Actually, the word they in the title refers to the present generation, to the we people and the fun we have in our life at the present time. To clarify the title, the story has been set in future. That is, it tells about 22nd century when we all will become just a past generation, a past century. How would be the world that time? Mostly, how will the students get educated during those coming days? Will there be any schools during those days? Will the system of education of the present generation that we all follow today, acquiring knowledge by attending schools every day, be exist till then? By the passing time, with the modern scientific inventions, we have realized changes in every field of our life. The system of education has also not been hidden and has been influenced a lot with these scientific inventions. We can understand the differences of the system of acquiring knowledge by reading its history. We can also realize how it was 5 years ago and a year before and how it is at present. With the invention of computers, we have realized a rapid changes in everything around us, and so has changed our education system. Earlier, our forefathers studied under the shade of trees, and they had only one or two teachers. Today, we have luxurious buildings as schools where the students go and acquire knowledge. Change is the demand of time. Without changes, life becomes dull. But imagine that one day our wishes to change our environment takes away every fun and entertainment we have. Then what kind of lifestyle we will have? So this chapter, The Fun They Had, also tells us about the changes that human generation will face in the field of education in future. You may also take an example of the present scenario. Our schools are closed because of the fear of spread and infection of coronavirus. But we are imparting education with the help of internet and YouTube and WhatsApp. So this system will get improved in future. You all are sitting at homes and getting education online. So this system of education will further be improvised and more techniques will be applied. But still, you all are missing your friends, teachers, and every fun you used to have in schools, aren't you? So the fun in the title is all the same fun we have together with our friends, teachers at our schools. So this fun will be one day only a topic of discussion in future, and the existence of schools will be a history. So let's enter the chapter that what actually the chapter tells us about. So this story, The Fun They Had, is written by an American writer, Isaac Asimov. And this story is a science fiction. It tells us the story of two young children named Tommy and Maggie, who live in the year 2157, that is the 22nd century, where they get education through computers at their homes. One day, they come through a printed book and learn something about the school that existed hundreds of years ago. It becomes a matter of great surprise for them because they are living in the age of moving electronic texts on the computers. So it is the year 2157. Margie makes a diary entry which reveals that Tommy has come across a book printed on paper. The pages of the book have turned yellow and wrinkled, which proves that it existed centuries ago. The book is peculiar in the sense that it had same words on it that the children had on their electronic texts on the computers. But they were not moving like that on a computer television screen. Tommy calls it a waste because once the book is read, it is of no use. The television screen had a million books on it and one cannot throw it away. Maggie also has the same opinion, but she is curious to know what the book is about. Tommy tells her that it is about school, but she hated school. Now she hated it more than ever because her mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test in geography and she had been doing worse and worse in every test. Her mother sends for the county inspector, who is a round little man. He takes the television teacher apart and sets it right within an hour, which only increases Margie's disappointment. He tells her mother that it was not Margie's fault, but the geography sector of the mechanical teacher was geared a little too quick and he has slowed that to an average 10-year level. As Margie was just 11 years old and Tommy just 13. He assures Margie and her mother that there will be no problem again. Margie is now curious to know about school that existed in the past. Tommy tells her that it is not their kind of school, that it is the old kind of school that they had centuries ago. The students had a human teacher who taught them and gave them homework and also asked them questions. Maggie argues that a man cannot be smart enough. Tommy further tells her that the teacher didn't live in the house. They had a special building and all the kids went there. The kids of same age learned the same thing. Now, it is Maggie's school time. She goes into the classroom, which is right next to her bed. And the mechanical teacher is on and waiting for her. She puts her homework in the slot with a sigh. She is still thinking about the old schools they had when her grandfather's grandfather was a little boy. All the kids from the whole neighborhood came laughing and shouting in the schoolyard like you all do, sitting together in the classroom like you all do, going home together at the end of the day like you all do. Those schools were far better than the schools of today, as Maggie thinks, because they offered great fun to the students. So Maggie is still continuing her imagination of the old school that her grandparents had during their times. So now here the chapter ends, and at the end we see that Maggie is still continuing with her imagination, and she is imagining her old school of her grandparents. And just tell me, students, who do you think that Maggie's grandparents are? See, Maggie's grandparents are we all are. Her grandparents belong to our generation. That the title they refers in the chapter. So this is all about the chapter. I hope you all understood the chapter and what moral feeling that the chapter tries to inculcate in our mind and heart. And I also know that you all are missing your school and you want to be back to school as soon as possible. We all are also missing you, my dear students. But we can't stop the process of educating you all. So, after completing this chapter, I have a very first question for you all, which you have to write answer in your notebook. And the question is, write down the question. Question number one, clarify the concept and meaning of the title, The Fun They Had. I want you all to write your own answers. Please don't share your answers with your friends. I want to see different answers from all of you. Maybe some points will be matched, but I don't want to see the ditto answers of all, that you all all will have no same answers. Okay, students, just see the page number 10. We have some activities to be done there. Some questions and answers are also there to be done from the chapter. So if you see the activity there, it is written there, calculate how many years ahead from now Maggie's diary entry is. See, we know that this chapter is a piece of diary writing written by Maggie, and it was written in 17 May 2157. And today we are living in which century? 21st century. And this diary entry is about the 22nd century. So, see, it's already a century, a difference of a century. But here we have to find out the actual years. Okay, how many years? Now see, we live in 2020. And now this diary entry is of 2157. So now you have to calculate, and you can easily calculate and take out the answer, that how many years ahead is this diary writing is of. Okay, now I know that you can do it. Now come to next exercise A, in which you have to answer some of the questions there. It is a very short question, short type of question answers. Now see, number one, it is written there, how old are Maggie and Tommy? Do you remember their age? See, as I remember, Maggie was about 11 years old and Tommy was 13 years old. So you should write, Maggie was 11 and Tommy was 13 years old. Or Maggie is 11 and Tommy is 13 years old, because the question is asked in present tense. So now come to another question. Question number two, what did Maggie write in her diary? So we know what she has written in her diary, because this chapter is, this whole story is in the form of her diary writing, Maggie. So what we know she has written? She has written about the book and the existence of the school. Okay, you will write this answer. Now number three, had Maggie ever seen a book before? So it was for the first time when she had seen a book. So that means she had not seen any book before that day when she found that book. So our answer would be no, Maggie had never seen a book before. Okay, short answer. Number four, what things about the book did she find strange? See, whenever she found the book, what she found the strange thing was, she found the words in the book as same as the words in which the books were there in their computer, okay, on the screen. But in computer they had moving screen, and in book the words did not move. So that was the difference, and that was the strange about the books that Maggie realized. Okay, now come to number five. What subjects did Maggie and Tommy learn? So we know that they learn about geography, and some of the other mechanical subjects were also there. You need to go through the chapter and you need to find out. Okay, so now you need to write about how you felt after reading this chapter. After the explanation of the chapter, how did you find the chapter? Did you find any soft corner inside you regarding the existence of the schools? How did you imagine that many years, that hundreds of years later, the schools that we come regularly to acquire education, acquire knowledge, its existence will not be longer. So the process of acquiring knowledge will be there, but the system will change. So okay, as I have already said, that change is the demand of time. Okay, so we are here, we are also the product of change. Whatever we have here, whatever the system we have here to acquire knowledge, it is also a changed version from the older one, as we compare to the system under which our mothers, they went. Okay, so the system has changed and it will continuously be changing. But still, we find some good things about the old things. So in future, the system we are in under which we are learning will be the older one. But some good things will be missed, like Maggie misses at the end of the story, because at home she is alone, she has no friends, she has Tommy only. But when she came to know about the school, that the children from the whole that colony, from the neighborhood, they went together to school, you know, and they sit together, they laughed, they made joke, they had fun, they played together. Okay, she was also in suspicion that how could a man be a teacher, because she always thought a computer smarter than man. However, she forgot that the same man had invented the computer also, isn't it? But still she is in confusion, isn't it? So still so many things will be missed in future when the school will not be there. So you also have to write if you all are also at home now, okay? If you just take it as a grant, that just think about it. If continuously it happens that you have to stay at home and you have to acquire a knowledge in this way only, the way in which we are teaching you latestly, okay, by this means of YouTube and this WhatsApp process. And slowly, slowly, if it continues that you would not be attending classes in school, now the classes in school will stop and you have to continue your study with the process of the present that time only. So how would you feel if you were not given, if you not get chance to come to school where you were coming regularly a month before? Okay, you need to write about it. Understood?